You recording me?
Yeah. Okay. What's up, what's up? It's your girl Josephine.
And your boy Raphael.
Coming to you with another video. Anyways, today we're going to do a mukbang, which means we're going to be eating and telling a story. So we're going to tell you guys about how
we met.
How did we meet? Anyways, so the way we met was one day, I was calling his sister. Because his sister was in Mexico. I was calling his sister, but I was calling his mom's phone. Because that's where I was. That was the way I used to get a hold of his sister. But she was in Mexico, and he answered the phone. And he was trying to be funny and stuff. Like, it was funny because I had never met him or anything. But he was like, for some odd reason, when I called him, he was being flirtatious or whatever. And I was a brat, you know. So, you know, I liked it. But anyways, so we talked to we talked for a few days and stuff. And then, my God, these tacos smell so good. Anyways, we talked for a few days and whatever, and I finally went to see him because his sister, his older sister, said, "Hey, Josephine, you want to come and see, want to come and chill over here?" And I'm like, "Okay, whatever. Just I'm gonna go chill over there. You know, take advantage and I can meet Raphael." So I told him I was gonna come visit him. He's like, "Okay, I haven't took a bath for 3 days," which he was lying because he used to like to joke around and stuff. And I'm like, "Whatever. Okay, so I'm getting dropped off, whatever." And he was not in the living room, but I thought he was because I didn't know how he looked. Remember, I was just getting to meet. I was gonna meet him right there.
Yeah.
And it was funny because his sister was in her world. His sister was in her world because of the fact that she had a new computer and she was just unboxing it. So since she was unboxing her computer, she wasn't worried about me. So she wasn't telling me, "Hey, you know, this is not my brother or anything." So I'm just sitting there looking stupid and stuff. And his friend is actually sitting on the couch. But at that moment, I didn't know it was his friend. I thought it was him. So I'm thinking to myself, "What the hell? This guy's like really not talking. This guy's super ugly. Like, what the hell is that?" I was regretting. Like, I literally wanted to turn around and walk home.
That's funny.
Sorry, you know who you are, but he wasn't my taste. That's what it was. Anyways. So finally, his sister tells me, "Hey, Josephine, Raphael's coming out of the bathroom now." Whatever. He was taking a shower. And I'm like, thinking to myself. And then to myself, thank God. Thank you, God, it is not him. So Raphael comes out. And he comes and he says hi, whatever. But it's so crazy because I've been waiting for him there. Remind you, I've been waiting there at the dummy. And he's about to leave. Him and his friend are about to leave. And I look at them, I was like, "You did not even make me come over here. You're about to leave and stuff." He's like, "No, I'm just going to go say hi to my family, my friends real quick. I'll be back." But then he told me, you know, "Come with me." But it was raining outside. It was not normal raining. It was storming outside. And this guy wants to go and say hi to everybody while it's freaking stormy. And then, so he told me, you know, "Here's my hat." I used to call him Pumpkin because he had he was matching me. I had a white shirt and some blue pants, some blue jeans. And he did too. But the difference was that he had an orange hoodie and he had a green hat. So I used to call him Pumpkin. That was my nickname for him when we first started because he looked like a pumpkin. And then, it's funny because he tells me, here's my hat, because my hair was really straight, right? I had straight in my hair to go over there, and you know, I was trying to look cute and stuff. And he gave me his hat, whatever. We started walking in the rain to say hi to all his family and friends because he had just got out of jail. He literally had just got out of jail a few days before the day I talked to him on the phone.
Yeah.
And he started introducing me to all his friends, his neighbor. "Hey, look at this. This is my friend. I just met her today." Like, that is so embarrassing. He was over here taking me to everybody's family's house. Hey, Primo, I haven't seen you so long. Hey, this is my friend. I just met her today." So they're looking at me like stupid, you know, like, what the heck? Like, he's bringing this girl. He has literally met her, and he's introducing her to the whole family. Because we never knew at the moment that, you know, we would be together this long. You know, we thought it was going to be a fling, and that's it. And then, damn, look at how it is now, right?
11 years.
11 years. Go ahead, baby. You tell him a little bit more, so I can eat.
Yep. Got out of jail. And she called, and I started talking to her. flirting a little bit here and there, you know? You know, I had game back then.
Back then.
Yeah. And, yeah, we started talking and, you know, I wanted to go see everybody, all my cousins and my family. I just got out of jail, so, you know, wanted to be out there again. And, but I was like, I ain't never going back to jail. And I'm like, forget that. I did a year and 8 months. And I said, I ain't never going back. I'm like, forget that. I'm like, I have 3 felonies. And from there, I'm not, no. Not no more. So, but, yeah, we kept talking. And look at now, we got two beautiful babies, a girl and a boy.
We had another one.
First girl, yeah. We had another one. And she
had a miscarriage.
Yeah, miscarriage. And because I was out there doing stupid stuff, you know. When I got a job, I still wanted to party. You know, I wanted to have fun, you know. But I quit. Everybody like to start doing bad things, you know. Or, you know, doing crazy stuff. I was like, no. But I wanted to party and party, you know. And I was just, I was trying to be with her and, you know, going with other girls and doing crazy things. And that's what happened. We had a miscarriage, but then from there, she forgave me, and we're here, 11 years. I stopped everything. I said, you know what? I'm gonna try to do the best thing for our family, cause I didn't want to lose a baby no more. And yeah, we had Genesis, and now we have a boy too. He's 3 years old. And maybe we'll have a little bit more, I don't know, in the future. But right now I'm thinking about business.
I have no more kids.
Oh yeah, she don't want none. I wanted 10.
I know. He's telling me I want a football field.
Yeah, I wanted
football
10.
Football team. I don't even know if you have a football team. But yeah, but, you know, we've been through hell. I'm back.
Yeah.
But you know, thank God in general, because that's the person who changed them, because if it wasn't for God, I just got my teeth. If it wasn't for God, we would not be together. You know, like, he would never change or anything. You know, it does take a role in a good woman to change a man, but it also takes God.
Everybody thought I wasn't going to change. Everybody thought that I was going to just be a, you know, not do nothing for my life and just be in the streets and doing stupid stuff. But I changed, I thank God for that change. And she helped me a lot. You know, she forgave me. And yeah, it's the best thing ever happened to me.
Aww.
Her and my kids. And yeah, I'm here. I changed a lot. I started dressing different, you know.
No more gangbangs.
No more gangs and nothing. You know, my brother right now, he's locked up for 22 to 40. You know, I'm like, man, and I told him when I got out of jail, I'm like, brother, don't do, you know, forget that. He told me, you know what he told me? He's like, you ain't my dad, and blah, blah, blah. He left, and now he's in jail for 22 to 44.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But it all had to do with my dad leaving us when we were younger. But he didn't left us. Kind of left us for another woman. And that's what happened. We just was going, you know, we went crazy. We were doing different things. My mom couldn't do, handle us because we were both
hard-headed
and, yeah. Yeah, we had ADHD, hyper. We used to take Ritalin and stuff like that. So my mom really couldn't handle us and my sister and,
it was too much for her.
Yeah, it was too much for her.
So they were crazy.
We were just doing dumb stuff. But
thank God.
Thank God I you know, she met her and now I'm doing better. I got my own business. My own trucking business and concrete business. And yeah. From there, I'm just trying to work. You know, I dress differently so nobody. You know, we moved out from Southwest Detroit. We moved to Linkin Park. It's the best thing I ever did too. We ever did. I stopped hanging out with the bad crowd and, you know, started hanging out with people that, you know,
positive people
that
want to grow in life.
That want to grow in life, and that's what I wanted to do. And
now we're here.
And now we're here. We got 11 years together, and we got two kids. Beautiful family. And we're happy, and I thank God, and we're trying to do the YouTube.
Yeah.
We stopped because she got
scared
of the last prank I did to her, and she didn't take it too well. So she's like, you know what? I ain't doing YouTube with you no more.
I know. I really wasn't.
Come on, let's do it.
It took a whole year for me to say, hey, okay, let's do YouTube again, because that scared me so bad. But this is our mukbang. Thanks for watching us.
Wow, she ate all them tacos.
I know.
Okay.
You got like 10 tacos.
Yeah.
Really he's gonna keep eating, you know. I ate three. You got 7 tacos. So anyways.
I eat a lot, but I'm trying to
diet.
Get a diet.
Thanks for watching us, everybody. Don't believe him. He's a liar. He says that and he be eating all this. But anyways, thanks for watching us, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. I forgot to tell you guys in the beginning. And turn on the little bell so you can get notified. Because yes. From here on, yep. There's going to be pranks. I'm sorry, I got to get off because my baby.
We're going to keep doing videos.